We may be police officers with training, but we're still human beings. About a night goes by that I don't come down those stairs, that I don't look at that door and relive that moment.
It was Easter, and it was about 10 o'clock at night, and I heard several shots.
It's just shocking, shocking.
I heard some banging noises downstairs. I came downstairs after retrieving my Walther PPK. As I walked down the stairs, I could see through the frosted glass of the front door that someone was out there. I opened the front door, and as I did so, there were two subjects there, wearing hoodies all cinched up, masks over their faces with just their eyes exposed. It turns out that the male perpetrator, Mr. Chapman, had been in the employ of an exterminating company that I had used and taking prescription drugs from customers. So he'd been in this house several times. And obviously he knew what was here, but apparently they thought that my wife and I were elderly and that we probably couldn't defend ourselves. And he was going to perform this little surprise attack on us and commit his robbery.
And guess who the surprise was on, right?
Well, exactly. The subject to my direct left said, "Hey, mother," he jumped at me. The subject to my right pulled out an aluminum baseball bat, raised it up to strike me. So I figured he's going to beat my brains out with it. And so I fell back into the hallway, pulled the Walther up, fired several shots at the subject, and the two turned around and started to run. He had fallen right there in the yard, and I could see that he was incapacitated. So I came back in, told my wife to call 911 and also call for an ambulance. I heard a car start. The backup lights came on, and my first instinct was that whoever's in that car plans to back over me in order to get the accomplice out of the front yard. So at that point, I turned around, raised my Glock, I fired several shots, and at that point, the car went into drive, and the subject pulled down the street at a high rate of speed. Turned out it was a woman, and they managed to find the other party and arrest her.
The homeowner was in fear for his life. He was acting in self-defense.
Residents in this neighborhood tell me you can't get any more safe than this rural area here in Maryland. But they also realize that what happened to Wes that night could have happened to them.
We couldn't imagine, easily could have been our house with our two little girls in it and my husband trying to defend our home. For us, it was just, thank God, it was Wes who was able to defend himself, who had firearms and who knew how to use them.
If I had not had that weapon in my hand and I had not been prepared, then I feel that I probably would have been killed. I ran thousands and thousands of calls during my law enforcement career. So many times you see people that are victims, homicides, and I was in the District of Columbia, which had the most harsh handgun laws in the country. And you think that if these people had a way to defend themselves, that this would have come out another way. So to do anything that would nullify a citizen's right to keep and bear arms is purely ludicrous.
Well, I don't own one, but yeah, it's definitely something I've been thinking about, sure.
I didn't know where the other subject was, and I felt that there was still a danger, so I threw the Walther onto the stairs because it was empty. I walked to my closet where I had a Glock 9mm in the closet, and certainly the fact that I had that additional weapon probably prevented me from being run over. It certainly came in handy.
He couldn't have picked the worst neighborhood or the worst house to go to.
He's an ex-cop.
In the two small streets here, we've got about 11 either active or retired law enforcement officers. And he was in my house. There was no way that he could not have known that I was a retired law enforcement officer because there are numerous pictures around here of me in my policing days. So you just think those kind of things can't happen to you, and believe me, they can.
Here you live in the state of Maryland, some of the toughest gun laws on the books. The governor just signed a law, and among other things, it restricts the number of rounds you can have in your ammunition clip to 10.
Common sense things that common sense tells us can work. Locking up the bad guys, and it will also ban military assault weapons to save lives.
Well, obviously, that restriction wouldn't have helped me that evening because I needed more than 10 rounds that night to defend myself and my wife.
You look at the suspect, a long record, no stranger to the police. Being in law enforcement surprise you?
No, not at all. Common sense would tell you he probably should have been in jail and not banging on my front door with a baseball bat, but that wasn't the case. Criminal justice system, they say it's about rehabilitation, but I saw people come in there and very, very few times did you ever see anyone convicted. state's attorneys would often, just because of the volume of cases, break felonies down to misdemeanors. The misdemeanors were handled as first offenses in a lot of cases when they weren't, and they'd walk out the door so that they can continue to prey on innocent people. And oftentimes they were laughing as they were leaving. As a consequence, you need to protect yourself.
The suspect that survived, the woman, she was sentenced to 4 years of a 15-year sentence. You think that was the right thing to do?
I don't feel that was the right thing to do. However, she was sentenced to the high end of the guideline, but I don't think these judges are allowed the latitude that they need to effectively enforce the laws.
I think that's not nearly enough for causing such anguish that West has to live with for the rest of his life, and his wife, the trauma that she was put through.
Did you go to her trial?
I did. I wanted that young lady to look me in the face and see that I was something other than a victim. I might be older and I might have my health problems, but I was still able to defend myself. And I would hope that that thought would play over and over in her mind if she ever decided to perpetrate a crime like that in the future. These politicians that are out of touch with people, they pass these laws and people are starting to take notice. I've been in law enforcement for 42 years now, and I can tell you, I never took a gun off of a criminal where it was registered to the criminal. It just seems to me to be a giant attempt to disarm the citizenry. The Second Amendment is not something that government can take away from us. It's in the Constitution. It was put there for a reason, and I damn anybody that thinks that we don't. People who are armed, that's their best defense. Police officers just can't respond quick enough to defend you in those life-threatening situations. You're pretty much left on your own. And once the sanctity of your home's been violated, I don't think you ever feel totally safe there again. Every time we come through this door, there's still blood stains in the concrete that seeped into it and stained it, and that's a constant reminder of that evening on March 31st.
I bet you count your lucky stars every day, huh?
I do indeed. And thank God for the Second Amendment.